Prior to her current position with Pearl River, Dr. Parker served as the chair of the Science and Health Department. This position provided her the opportunity to instruct students in anatomy and physiology and microbiology while supervising science and health faculty. Dr. Parker continues to teach microbiology in an online setting as well as traditional fitness courses here at PRCC. Parker graduated from the University of Southern Mississippi in 2002 with a Bachelor's of Science in Biological Sciences and in 2008 with a Doctorate in Biochemistry. She is married to Adam Parker and they have one daughter, Kara, and two fur babies, a French bulldog named Diesel and a Corso named Zeta. Please join me in giving a warm welcome to Dr. Parker.
Coming today. Are you okay to hear me without the microphone?
Yes.
Am I good? Yeah. Okay, because I really like to move around. I can't stand to feel like a prisoner behind that podium. So when I was invited to give a lecture in this honors series this semester, I thought, well, this is a great opportunity for me to do a little research on something that I encounter every day. And the nerd in me thought, well, I'm a biochemist. I probably use artificial sweeteners maybe more than I should because I'm so worried about my health and eating right. This is probably what I need to take a look at. And I have to tell you, I was honestly a little surprised by some of the research that I looked into. So I am a biochemist, but I'm going to try to not bore you with too much chemistry. I'm going to try to make this something that you can actually have something that you take away with you when you leave from here today, okay? So I thought I would just start today by asking you a question. It is not a trick question. The answer is not water. I want to know, what do you really think would be the best option? If you were forced to drink either 5 regular Cokes in one day or 5 Diet Cokes in one day, which would be better for you? So what do you think? So who thinks option one? Who thinks option two is better for you? Okay. I have a feeling that a lot of you think that option one is better because the title of the talk is artificial sweeteners, right? What's the true cause? They must be terrible. Well, if we're going to talk about artificial sweeteners, let's first define what is an artificial sweetener. Artificial sweetener is really more of a generic term. They're more properly called non-nutritive sweeteners because they have no nutritional value. Technically, the body is not supposed to be able to process these sweeteners. And I think we all probably recognize the nice little colorful packages, right? We all know them by their more trademark name. But you actually really need to be able to recognize the true chemical name. Because if you're trying to find some of these and look to see if they're in your food, you're reading an ingredient list, they're not going to say things like equal or sweetener. They're going to say aspartame. So these are the 6 FDA-approved artificial sweeteners. Artificial sweeteners, according to the FDA, were developed to help in the maintenance of health under certain health disorders. Okay? So when these were developed and originally studied, their purpose was for people to have a sweet option when they really needed to steer away from sugar. These were never originally intended to be something that took the place of sugar in everyone's everyday lives. Okay? So wouldn't you agree you probably recognize a lot of these? Stevia, or more commonly called Truvia, is one of your newer ones that has the least amount of research. But don't let it fool you. Just because it's researched the least doesn't mean it's the healthiest of the 6. And that's what a lot of your current TV commercials try to convince you of. Well, they don't tell you, well, this is just the one we know the least about, so it's the healthiest. It's natural. Not really. So, gotta give you a little chemistry, or I would be hurting myself here. This is it. This is the only chemistry slide, I promise. So at the top up here, this is the chemical structure for glucose and fructose. These are 2 common sugars, that natural sugars, that when we ingest them, they dissolve in our saliva and we get that sweet taste, okay? That sends a signal to your brain that says you've ingested something sweet, your body needs to do something with it. So when they developed all these artificial sweeteners, they had to keep some similarities. So you see they all kind of have that same ring structure. So when those rings, and see this is stevia, it looks a lot like sucrose. Those rings are what make you think you've got something sweet. Okay, so their job is to trick our brain into thinking we've had something sweet, but not affect the rest of the body. Okay, so, all right, we understand what an artificial sweetener is. Why do we need these artificial sweeteners? Because I told you, they were originally designed for people that were diabetic or obese, and we had to have something. Well, all of the people in this room, or not all, maybe most of the people in this room, we need artificial sweeteners because we want to be slim and trim, but I'm not giving up my cake, or I'm not giving up my ice cream, right? So that's why we need these artificial sweeteners. So, well, if we want sweet, why not just have sugar, right? What does sugar do to us? Do any of you really understand what sugar does? So let me give you the very, very simplistic view of what sugar does for us, okay? When we eat something sweet, immediately that sugary substance sends a chemical to our brain that says you've eaten something sweet. Your body then knows, I need to do something with that sugar, okay? So your body takes the sugar in, goes through your stomach, you digest it, the sugar enters your bloodstream. When the sugar is in your bloodstream, your pancreas secretes a hormone called insulin, okay? That's a good hormone. That hormone tells you you have sugar available, do something with it. What are your options to do? Number one, if I'm active, my body's going to use that sugar to make energy. Or if I'm not active at the moment, my body's going to use that sugar as a storage, storing it in the form of glycogen so I can use it later. Okay, well, that's all great. Well, what if I decide that I'm going to eat 2 bags of gummy bears today? And don't get me wrong, I could eat 2 bags of gummy bears in about 10 minutes if I really set my mind to it. What am I going to do then? Well, my body's going to continue to secrete that insulin to the point that I can't store the sugar in the form of glycogen anymore. So guess what your body begins to store that sugar as? Fat. It doesn't directly turn into fat. My biochemistry instructors would, you know, be so mad at me for saying that. But in a roundabout way, if you eat too much sugar, it will cause you to store excess fat. Okay? So let's say I eat those 2 bags of gummy bears today. I eat those 2 bags of gummy bears tomorrow. And then the next day, and the next day. All my body's ever doing is being exposed to insulin. So I have insulin exposure all the time. If I come stand next to you, and I poke you in the arm over and over and over again, eventually, what are you going to have to do? You're going to slap me. Or you're going to have to start ignoring that, right? So when you have that insulin exposure all the time, your body begins to ignore that insulin. So too much sugar can actually cause excessive weight gain because your body's storing extra fat. And then it can cause insulin resistance, where you begin to ignore your insulin. And look at all of the health effects you can have from insulin resistance. It can lead to diabetes. It can lead to increases in your bad cholesterol, plaque formation in your arteries. So many different diseases, all because you ingested too much sugar all the time. So now all y'all that said you're going to pick those 5 Coca-Colas, you're starting to think maybe you had the wrong answer, right? Sugar can be bad, right? Guess what else sugar can do? It makes you want more sugar. Whenever you eat sugar, it sends a signal to your brain. Your brain secretes a neurotransmitter called dopamine. Dopamine makes you feel good. So when you eat sugar, it makes you happy. It makes you want to eat more sugar. As you do that more and more and more, your brain has to secrete more and more dopamine to keep up with that want you have for sugar. So if we compare brain scans from someone who is addicted to cocaine when they're exposed to cocaine and someone who eats a lot of sugar when they're exposed to sugar, that's very scary similar, isn't it? So people who are addicted to sugar can get the same high that someone that's addicted to cocaine can get. So there really isn't such thing as sugar addiction. So gosh, we need to do something, right? What is the solution? We've got to have a solution. This sugar is terrible for us. Well, this is our solution is. This is one of my favorites. And that one, oh, every morning, right? Oh my gosh, no, sugar-free gum is good for me, right? Well, let's think about this. Here's what we see a difference in sugar content. Here's the amount of sugar in a regular Coke. Well, here's the amount of sugar in a Diet Coke and a Coke Zero, right? We fixed our problem. Took all the sugars away. Well, what about this? Yogurt's super healthy, right? And when I go, I need to buy the light one, right? Because it's less calories. That one's better for me, right? Because, I mean, if I look at this label, it doesn't say it's full of artificial sugars, right? It's even endorsed by Weight Watchers, right? And Oprah Winfrey says Weight Watchers is the way to go, right? So, I mean, obviously this is a good thing. Guess what? If we look way over here, teeny tiny in the ingredient list, it says aspartame. Do you remember what that is? That's equal. That's the blue packet. Right? So aspartame is the blue packet. But you may not even realize that was there. Doesn't say anything about it on the front. Alright, so what's the true cost? What am I trying to get to, right? I've been telling you for the whole time in talking how bad sugar is. And so we obviously invented all these artificial sweeteners. What really happens to you when you ingest artificial sweeteners? And I know there's a lot of words on that slide, but what happens to you when you ingest an artificial sweetener? When you ingest, it dissolves in your saliva, sends a signal to your brain, makes your brain think, ooh, she just ate something sweet. So that makes you happy, right? Dopamine's released. And all the parts of your intestines and your digestive tract, your pancreas says, oh, she ate something sweet, let's secrete insulin. Does that insulin have anything it can work on? No. So when that artificial sweetener is in your body, you're secreting insulin. Your brain is secreting dopamine, getting addicted to that artificial sweetener. Artificial sweeteners are even sweeter than regular sugar, so it makes you crave even more sweet than the original sugar would have made you crave. So if I'm constantly secreting this insulin, and my body has nothing to work on, what's going to happen to me? I'm going to ignore that insulin, right? And so I just put the same slide back up there. Insulin resistance can lead to increasing your bad cholesterol, weight gain. It puts your body in storage mode. Cardiovascular disease, elevated blood pressure. 10 years ago, we thought if you were a diabetic, it didn't matter how much of the artificial sweetener you ate because you just need to stay away from sugar. That was your problem. Now we see that people are having an increase in the loss of glucose tolerance. It's making people that are diabetic in even worse situations if they're ingesting too much of this artificial sweetener. And the more you eat, the more you want more and more sweet. And if you're on artificial sweetener, you're not going to eat sugar. You're going to eat more artificial sweetener. Another problem with artificial sweeteners. How many people in this room are guilty of, I'll take a double cheeseburger and fries and a Diet Coke because, you know, I'm not going to drink my calories, right? I'm going to eat my calories. So in this situation, I've now had the sugar and the artificial sugar. Goodness, is there a solution? Well, I told you in the beginning, I'm kind of a nerd, and I did do some research before I decided just to get up here and start rambling today. What does the true scientific research tell us? It can only tell us what there's a risk of. None of the scientific studies with humans have been conclusive when it comes to artificial sweeteners. We cannot control for genetics. We cannot control for all environmental factors. It's against the law to do testing on humans, so there's only so many things we can do with humans, all right? So what we do know, there are scientific papers to back up an increased risk of coronary heart disease, chronic kidney disease, an increase in your likelihood of developing diabetes, an issue with glucose tolerance if you're already diabetic, and then one of the newest risks is with dementia, for people who ingest too large of a quantity of artificial sweetener. Now, what's too large of a quantity? That depends on the physician that is doing the study. There is no magic answer to that. So what about the mouse that got cancer, right, from aspartame? That was, I remember that 15 years ago. I can remember my grandma telling me, I'm still going to drink sweetener. That's what I like, right? Well, there are studies with mice, and they fed those poor little mice dump truck loads of artificial sweetener, and those mice did develop cancer. And the ones that were never exposed to artificial sweetener did not develop cancer. But I don't know about you, I don't plan on eating a dump truck load of sweetener anytime soon. But can you compare that to a human? Genetically, you are similar to a mouse, whether you want to think that or not. So the way I look at this with my scientific background is this right here tells me that I probably need to really expose my body to artificial sweeteners in moderation, just like you should control the amount of sugar that you ingest in your body. So to go back to my original question, so which one's better? One is just as bad as the other, right? So in reality, yeah, it kind of is a true question, right? Water is really what you should drink. But am I telling you to never drink another diet soda again? No. If I'm in the mood for a Coke Zero, trust me, I'm going to have a Coke Zero. If I want some no sugar added Blue Bell homemade vanilla ice cream, I'm going to have some ice cream. But I'm not going to eat it every day. The majority of the drink that I ingest is going to be water. You have to just control the amount of sugar as well as the amount of artificial sweetener. So the end of this talk, and what I thought would be a good way to end this, would be to say there is no magic solution. If you want to be fit and trim, moderate your sugar, moderate your artificial sweeteners. Anything you do in excess is bad. If you want to know what causes cancer, you could probably find a scientific paper that links just about anything to cancer if you really look hard enough. Because if you have anything in excess, it's going to cause negative effects on your body. And then I really thought this quote was just a really good way to sum all this up. When it comes to artificial sweeteners, the answer is not to find a fake chemical solution so we can keep eating our favorite junk food. The answer is to omit the junk and accept that better nutrition is the answer to a healthier, longer life. So with that, if you have any questions and you want a more nerdy chemistry answer, I'd be more than happy to answer. But I wanted this to be just a little bit more for everyone in the room. So thank you very much for coming to listen to me. Go ahead, Ms. Clark.
What about sugar alcohol?
Sugar alcohols are processed completely different in your body. The number one problem with a sugar alcohol that's been identified is it causes excess water loss. So then your body begins to move to dehydration mode, and then that can cause a whole new list of side effects. So if we're comparing a sugar alcohol to an artificial sweetener, maybe a little bit better when it comes to things like, you know, heart disease and things of that nature. Comparing it to sugar, probably still the same effect. Moderation is best. A lot of people get really bad intestinal upset, diarrhea, things like that from sugar alcohol. It's a good way to lose weight though, right? I mean, you're trying to do that. Yes, those water flavoring packets, they are basically artificial sweetener with some other flavors stuck in there. The same thing as corn and sweetener.
What about those packets that they say
pure or like they say? Oh, I have to read the label. I don't know exactly what's in those.
I looked at them and I don't see any of those. They of course have a
different
taste.
Yeah, I would honestly have to read the label. I don't know. Yes, ma'am? Well, that's just to advertise. That makes it sound better. Natural means that where they originally got it from was a plant, but they didn't just purify it from a plant and put it in a package. They got a chemical from a plant and then chemically modified it and call it natural. So it's not really natural. And that's honestly, is it better for you? Well, we'll tell you in 10 years. You know, saccharin, aspartame, they've all been around a really long time. You know, when Splenda first came out, do y'all remember that Splenda was magical when it first came out? It's the one that doesn't hurt you.
It's the one that tastes just like sugar.
It tastes just like sugar, right? Yeah, well, now we know better. It fits in the category just like all the rest do. Yes, sir?
Okay, what about the new water they have out now? It tastes like just like juice.
The vitamin water?
Not the vitamin water. It's actually in a blue. They got like different flavors, like the strawberry, the kiwi.
I'd have to look at it. I honestly don't know.
Are you talking about the ones that release? Are you talking about that? That's the release stuff?
Yeah.
I don't know. You can get them at some gas stations around here, but it has like.
Take a picture of one and bring it to me next time you come to exercise.
They're pretty cool.
I just don't know.
I mean, they're probably not good for
you. Do you think we'll ever see an improvement or some kind of, more transparency in the way these companies market these kinds of things?
Nope. It'll never be controlled. It's almost along the lines of free press, right? They can say whatever they want to say. And the general public usually doesn't have the background knowledge to really pick apart what they were telling. That was one reason I put the yogurt label in there. They make that yogurt look fabulous for you. And they don't tell you really anything about having anything artificial in it unless you read the ingredient list.
So no matter how much, after regulation.
Right, because the FDA is going to stay out of it. The FDA is going to say, that's why the FDA statement says artificial sweeteners are here for people who need it. People that are diabetic, people that are obese for some health reason that's causing that obesity. They're going to stay out of it. Yes, ma'am?
I remember reading somewhere where some of these artificial sweeteners are actually banned in other countries, that they don't, they're not approved for consumption.
Well, I don't know about these six, but there's other artificial sweeteners. Some are not FDA approved in the United States. They are FDA approved in other countries. So, I mean, I'd have to look these six up, but there are, you can go to other countries and actually drink a diet soda. I don't know if you guys have ever done this. You go to another country and drink a diet soda, sometimes it will taste different. And some of that difference is the artificial things that are put into the soda that you're drinking. That's what, just drink water, right? But then we could have a whole nother lecture on what's in your tap water, right? Y'all want to have it next year, what's in your tap water? Yeah.